Can protein shakes be used by diabetics for better glycemic control of our blood sugars? What kinds of protein control blood sugars better, but at the same time, increase muscle mass thus and increase metabolism? Would they also help in getting rid of that toxic fat, which is the cause of insulin resistance, thus diabetes in the first place? How would we know which ones to buy and which ones to avoid? I'll cover all of that for you today, including how to set up your own test to determine the very best ones for you to use. But before we begin, let me welcome all of you resilient diabetics out there. This is the channel we turn ordinary, struggling diabetics into, you know it already, extraordinarily well-controlled diabetics. If you don't know who I am and you're brand new to this channel, I welcome you. My name is Jay Sampat, and I am an insulin-dependent diabetic diagnosed a little over 6 years ago. So, the proud owner of a pancreas that's gone on a permanent and lifelong vacation. So not only am I a diabetic, just like you, where we will be walking that walk and talking that talk together, but I do also have a university bachelor of science degree in nutrition dietetics, and that does come in handy in discussing all the intricacies of being a diabetic. My goal is to put 4 years of chemistry, biochemistry, organic chemistry, and some human physiology into around a 10-minute or so presentation so that you know how your diabetic body works better than, dare I say, your doctor? I just did. The unique information presented today will only be found here on this channel, The Resilient Diabetic. New, life-changing episodes are generally released weekly. So if you want to learn more and you want to be notified by YouTube that a new video has been released, the only way to do that is to hit the subscribe button followed by the gray notification bell. Then you have to choose turn on all notifications. And of course, if you liked what you've learned today, please smash that like button for me. But before we begin, we must understand what are the roles of protein and how does it work in the body. The term complete protein refers to the amino acids, the building blocks of protein. Kind of think of them like different kinds of sizes of Lego blocks. They are around 20 different amino acids that can form a solid protein. 9 of them your body cannot produce on its own. These 9 are what's known as essential amino acids because they need to be consumed through our food. Why again? Because we can't make them ourselves. To be considered a complete protein, one must have adequate amounts of all 9 essential amino acids. Our bodies use multiple combinations of these amino acids from our foods to form and make proteins. What is unique about protein? Unlike fats and carbohydrates, it is used for structural components and all other types of substances for our bodies, from hormones to muscle tissue, blood cells, enzymes, hair, nails, and many, many others, including our immune system. As long as the body has access to the right given proportions of these building blocks or amino acids. Most vegetable protein sources are what's known as incomplete because they miss one or more of these essential amino acids. Animal-based proteins are considered complete as they contain all 20 different amino acids. That includes eggs and dairy-based proteins. We do not, however, need every essential amino acid in every bite of food at every single meal. We only need sufficient amounts of each amino acid each day. These incomplete foods don't need to be eaten at the same time in order for us to be used to build protein. We just need to eat these complementary proteins within 24 hours. So our first question is, can we as diabetics substitute protein shakes for greater glucose control and better overall health? The answer to that is unfortunately a yes and a big no. So here is the first groundbreaking caveat you must know and understand. A protein powder is considered a dietary supplement. The FDA leaves it up to the manufacturers to evaluate the safety and the labeling of the product. So there is no way to know if that protein powder contains what the manufacturer claims. There is no one out there to regulate the protein-based supplement industry. You are literally at the mercy of that producer. So you must stick to the name brand companies, not the cheap small versions. Being actually in the bodybuilding industry for over 25 years plus, and having used and consulted a few of these startup protein powder supplement companies, I can tell you firsthand, they are there first to make a profit. And by any means possible, that does include false labeling and cutting corners by adding in cheap fillers and ingredients. I will say this again, the supplement industry as a whole is not there to improve your health. They are there to market themselves as vital, necessary, and unique so that they can essentially take your money. Second caveat, protein supplements do not magically help you build muscle or lose weight. What many people do not realize about protein powders and shakes is that unless you have a solid diet plan in place with whole foods that are low in carbohydrates, you can very well end up gaining weight or even making your diabetes even worse. And I will explain shortly why certain shakes can exponentially make your diabetes worse. For example, using supplements or meal replacements like Glucerna, Boost, Ensure to supplement a meal plan could be disastrous. Drinking those supplements on top of whatever's eaten for a meal or snack could contribute additional calories and worse, carbohydrates. Always read the nutritional facts labels to determine what is in the product so you can decide how you can fit that into your eating plan. Protein shakes are often highly processed and many contain a lot of added sugars, unbeknownst to you. And they will not use terms that you're familiar with like straight sugar. Remember, there are at least 61 different names for sugar that can be listed on a food label. The use of sugar alcohols is also highly prevalent. And I've covered sugar alcohols in detail and disclosed which ones will spike your blood sugars. I'll put that video link in the description box below for you to review. So my first important tip, the protein supplement of your choice must have 3 grams or less of carbohydrates per serving. Third, protein can and will raise both blood sugars and insulin levels. And this can be both good and bad. Excessive protein or amino acids can be converted into other storage products or oxidized as fuel through a process known as gluconeogenesis. That is where the body can produce glucose from protein. The impact of dietary protein on blood sugars has long been a topic of extreme confusion. Early, poorly done research hypothesized that 100 grams of ingested protein produces between 50 to 80 grams of glucose. Later research showed it was around 10 grams of glucose that could show up in circulation following the consumption of 50 grams of protein. So that roughly equates to about 1 gram of glucose can be produced for every 5 grams of protein consumed. So if you're like me, an insulin-dependent diabetic, you must account for the rise in blood sugars with the right corresponding type of insulin and the amounts. If you're a diabetic with compromised pancreas and you're facing resistance issues, you must be prepared to see a rise in blood sugars too. Remember, the only macronutrient that does not cause a rise in blood glucose is fats. What are one of the major benefits to supplementing protein into a diet? Protein actually takes longer to digest than carbohydrates, so it will increase the feeling of being full, which is known as satiety. You will not feel hungry after consuming a protein shake like you would a carbohydrate-rich snack, which means less insulin requirements, thus less bodily inflammation. Weight loss can occur as long as a protein powder is used to replace carbs and fats. Adding protein to an existing high carbohydrate, high fat diet will not lead to fat loss or weight loss or better glycemic control. So do not depend solely on shakes for protein intake because you will miss out on the minerals and other valuable nutrients that protein-rich foods provide. Let me get into the 2 types of protein supplements that may benefit you. They are called whey and casein proteins. Casein and whey are the 2 types of proteins found in cow's milk, making up 80 and 20% of the milk protein respectively. Both casein and whey are actually what's known as byproducts of cheese production, but they are both different from one another. Whey protein is a complete protein, and it's actually better suited for workouts because one, it is quickly absorbed. Two, it has a much superior amino acid profile. It contains more of the branched chain amino acids, which are leucine, isoleucine, and valine. These branched chain amino acids activate certain pathways in the body that stimulate muscle protein synthesis, which is the process of making muscle. Casein is also a complete protein, but unlike whey, which gets rapidly absorbed, casein digests slowly, making it good for both an in-between meal protein shake and before bed. What's more, there are some other factors to consider from my experience. Casein protein powder is generally more expensive than whey. Whey protein powder tends to mix better than casein does. Whey protein powder often has better consistency and taste than the casein will. Some protein powders incorporate both whey and casein into one blend. Blending these proteins together can help maintain a positive protein balance over a course of time. Now, choosing one over the other won't necessarily bestow better results in the gym or markedly improve your health. So select one you prefer or buy a blend that contains both. What about the plant-based protein supplements such as brown rice, soy, hemp, and pea proteins? Are they a nutritious alternative? In most cases, plant-based proteins are considered an incomplete protein, lacking some of the 9 essential amino acids we've talked about. There is one exception, soy-based protein powders. They do contain all 9 amino acids. However, you have to do your homework when it comes to the plant-based proteins. The ones that I would caution on is actually the soy-based powders. And it's a strong personal decision based on the need to avoid any of the phytoestrogen-based compounds, which cause hormonal disturbances and imbalances. I personally must stay away from everything soy-related with a 10-foot pole if I want to stay lean and muscular. The second ingredient I want you to avoid like the plague is vegetable oils and any other commercial fats. You never, never want to see that on the label. That in itself will make your diabetes worse. We as diabetics have higher risk of kidney disease. And if your kidneys are not working well due to years of excessive carbohydrate consumption, eating more protein than one needs may cause further damage. So you must consult your doctor first. Now that you've consulted your doctor, you've gone out and you've bought your new protein powder. What next? Well, it's time to test it. This will determine, one, are the labels accurate? Two, is your body responding positively to this brand of protein? Third, and most important, what is happening to our blood sugars? When you test your new protein powder supplement, I want you to only use water to mix it in. Find a time of the day where you can test your blood sugars, both before, 1 and 2 hours after. Make sure when you're testing, you also keep your daily food intake constant too. So in other words, one day you have oatmeal for breakfast and then you test your protein powder for lunch. And the next day you have an omelet and then you test your protein powder for lunch. That will actually influence the results and compound the unknowns. Test at the same time with the same meals both pre and post trials. Your glucose meter will be your final judge and juror for what fits you the best. What you may find out is that these protein powders, if void of any carbohydrates, could actually decrease your blood sugar levels. Why? Because of the mild increase in insulin production they cause. And that actually could be a good thing. So the number one rule is to never, never mix your protein powders with any carbohydrate-rich liquids, or even worse, make a smoothies out of them with fruit in it. That not only ruins the health benefits of the protein supplement, but it will exponentially make your diabetes worse because now you're putting your pancreas under extreme pressures to produce even more insulin to rapidly counteract all that toxic inflammatory sugars coming in. That will in turn again make you hungry, causing this vicious circle of blood sugar swings. Remember, protein powders usually come in a multitude of flavors, like chocolate, vanilla, and banana. You do not and should not have to add any carbohydrate-based liquid to that mix. Second rule, I would actually suggest you sticking to the bodybuilding-based protein powders, the ones marketed for us bodybuilders. Ask for the ones that have been around the longest and are the best sellers. There's a reason for that. They have far too much to lose if they cut corners and cheapen their own brands. Plus, there are actual watchdogs out there who test their products. You will know immediately when one starts to add in fillers, binders, or cheap substitutes. Get the smallest sizes possible. If you can get samples, great. Contact many of the companies. Some are more than willing to send you samples. You want to try out as many different brands as possible based on where you are. I'll create another important playlist for you with videos related to diabetes. In the video, why is physical activity so important? We discuss physical activity and exercise as a way of speeding up the rate of remission for type 2 diabetics and at the same time prevent what's known as double diabetes in type 1 or type 1.5 diabetics such as myself. You will also know what causes diabetes in the first place. And second, most importantly, understand why each and every one of us diabetics are different from one another. This is why protein supplements may work for some diabetics and not for others. If you're on your desktop or laptop, I want you to use the mouse to click that box. If you're on your mobile device, I want you to tap that with your fingers. The first link is to subscribe to this all-important life-changing channel. The second is the link to that all-important playlist mentioned above. So, have a great and productive day, and we'll see you soon with another new episode, which I said are always released weekly. Bye for now.